It didn't look like something that was too good to be true. It was an ultra-conservative offer, and I invested in it. It can happen to anybody and will happen to anybody.
Harold Scrooby is a seasoned investor, but last year he was fleeced out of $700,000 in a sophisticated investment scam.
These scammers were paying Google to put their ads on. The prospectus they sent me was brilliant. It was beautiful. They can emulate anything now online.
In 2022, Aussies lost a record $3.1 billion to scammers, up 80% on the previous year. Most of that down to investment scams.
As with all scams, consumers are often embarrassed when they get caught. We see large losses in relation to investment scams because of their nature. It's estimated that up to 30% of consumers don't report losses at all.
Scams becoming not only more prevalent, but increasingly harder to spot. Criminals are employing emerging tech to impersonate the website, email address, or number of a company or bank, even slipping fake texts into existing message threads.
This message came in. I assumed it was from my bank. It wasn't.
Scammers are even using AI to impersonate loved ones in distress, calling for help and cash. And as scams get smarter, the amount of money gets bigger. In 2022, tricked Aussies parted with an average of nearly $20,000 each, double on the previous year.
It's not just about the numbers. Behind each one of those dollars is a person that's experienced emotional distress that can flow onto their household and to their business. So the real cost is much higher.
Pressure is now building on the banks to boost customer protection by checking the account numbers match the account name on transfers.
We are seeing some really good initiatives overseas, and Australia should learn from those.
When the UK's biggest banks adopted a similar system in 2019, it led to a 35% drop in the amount of money lost.
I felt like an idiot. The system is against you and the scammers know it.
Well, joining us is technology futurist Chris Riddell. Chris, this feels kind of out of control, is it?
It is. I mean, you look at how big these operations are getting now with scams. I mean, if you look at also in India, that's where the majority of these scams are coming from. These are businesses. These scam businesses are being running as massive operations as call centres, and they're getting bigger. It's become a huge industry.
It's scary stuff, Chris. In the UK, they've managed to cut scams by a third. Can you take us through what they're doing over there?
Yeah, look, the UK a couple of years ago were forced by the regulatory body to implement this name check technology where before you send the money, the system in front of you that you're using actually checks that the money is going to the destination that you think. So it gets the bank account details and it verifies the sender. And here in Australia, we have only just actually seen Commonwealth Bank just start to implement that recently. So we're a bit behind the times. But even if you look at the Dutch banking system, in 2017, they actually implemented this technology and it resulted in about an 80% reduction in fraud.
Chris, on the banks, I'm constantly amazed at how little they sometimes get involved when you transfer large amounts of money. Should they be doing more?
Yeah, they should. And I think the thing here in Australia is we feel like it's a bit of a favour when the banks pay us back. There actually aren't any rules to force them to do it. So the banks do need to do more, but this is going to be driven largely by the ACCC.
I think the main point of that question was that Steve wanted to tell us he transfers large sums of money.
Oh, I just want it to be safe when I do it.
Yeah, well. they say, what is it, the war between locksmiths and thieves is never over, and it feels a bit like this, that, like, technology is just moving so fast on this front. The scammers just seem to be able to get ahead so quickly. Do you think authorities can ever really actually catch up to what they're doing?
The thing is, if you look at it, I mean, it's across many industries. We have this same problem. The security agencies or industry are governed by a whole set of rules, and that really actually does slow them down. These scam businesses that are running these call centres, they can do whatever they want. I mean, they're using platforms like Amazon to be able to use ChatGPT and artificial intelligence type technology that we've been hearing a lot about recently. So they can move really quickly, whereas the banks are governed and have rules that make them a lot slower. So that's the biggest challenge that we're starting off with. The second part is that government really need to move faster with this. But technology is the challenge. Understanding where the boundaries of all of this, that's a big problem.
Chris, could there be a plot twist, though? Could we flip the script and actually use AI, ChatGPT, to catch the scammers? Could it be used for good?
Well, I think we should actually get them all to fight each other. We could watch these AI systems fight each other. But if you want something really interesting to do, go onto YouTube and go and watch a few of these videos where these scam hunters, or scam busters, as they're called, they actually hack into the CCTV systems in these call centres in India, and they then expose them. And you just see how big these operations are, and they're growing exponentially. It's gone crazy. Go and have a look on YouTube.
Chris, I know what I'm doing after I'm a Celeb tonight. Thank you for your time.
Thanks, guys.